Hey everyone, it's Dr. Romani. Now, during a recent meeting I had with my team, they told me about something that really concerned me. They were telling me that there's something out there that's called a karmic relationship. Now, I had no idea what they were talking about. I thought it was maybe they were talking about some sort of dreamy, predestined love story, which also concerned me enough. But when I was like, karmic relationships, I was like, what is this? And when I then did a deeper dive and really read about it, I was like, oh no. Because it felt like one more way for people to potentially get stuck in narcissistic relationships. Well, I know until recently I had never heard of this. Please drop a comment if you have heard of this type of relationship and already have a sense, especially when it comes to the world of narcissistic relationships, how problematic this is. Now, most of the blogosphere and internet space that writes about this thing, this whole karmic relationship thing, it's all very listicle. They list all of the characteristics of karmic relationships. And I scoured more than a few of these to find out what the characteristics of a karmic relationship are. There was a lot of overlap, but I made note of all of them. Now, hold on to your hats, folks, because you are going to love this list of what makes a karmic relationship. Ready? Instant connection, volatile, lots of red flags early on, frustrating, unpleasant, the relationship feels obsessive and time-consuming, lots of highs and lows, repetitive fights and playing out the same cycles repeatedly, they play upon your insecurities and fears, they bring out the least desirable aspects of yourself, they are exhausting, they require a lot of justification to keep them going. Just sit with that for a minute, okay? Now, all of you, and all my this YouTube world could talk to me right now and say it out loud, and I could hear it. I know what you'd be saying. You'd say, damn, that sounds like trauma bonding. That's just a narcissistic relationship, right? Right. So trying to package this and spin this and call it a karmic relationship, it's this idea that this kind of a relationship is meant to be a place given to you to work through traumas and issues from your past life, and that it's a place to learn that lasts as long as you need to get the lessons, I suppose, to which I say, oh, hell no. Because after you have been through the messy nightmare of any narcissistic relationship, sure, you went through it. I didn't want that for you. But I guess any of us can try and see what was learned. But to frame one of these relationships as karmic, like by design, because it was going to teach you something, no, 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 no. Nobody should stay in a relationship that is harming them because they think it is some sort of karmic workshop on trauma healing. When I read these various blogs and articles about karmic relationships, I gotta tell you, my heart sank, because my biggest concern is that people will read this stuff who are stuck in narcissistic relationships and may remain in these toxic relationships even longer because it's already hard enough to leave. And now they believe they're working through some karmic lessons. And you know, on this channel, I never pull cultural rank, but I'm going to pull some cultural rank here. I get to be the karma boss right now. I was raised in a very Hindu family, and I was raised on this stuff. And this is actually not how karma works, so just saying. So I was even more troubled by the misuse of that word to rationalize these difficult relationships. Now, a person who is in a narcissistic relationship may believe, oh, this is just my karmic relationship, and so I'm going to stick it out for some metaphysical reason that they've got. I'm sorry, I can't get behind that, and I'm concerned that people are getting information out there which makes them think that they should stick it out. Listen, I do agree that vulnerabilities to narcissistic relationships and trauma-bonded situations can emanate from our early histories, but not always. some folks from really happy families who have never met a narcissist and who have great self-esteem also fall for toxic relationships and narcissistic people. Toxic folks are equal opportunity abusers. And that past life piece, listen, I got no skin in that game, but I cannot get behind the idea that whatever past life thing is being worked out is going to be worked out by staying with a toxic, abusive person. Now, many, if not most people, do not, if they do learn from their narcissistic or toxic relationships, they get more harm than they get lessons. Most people in these relationships simply end up harmed, devastated, full of self-blame and regret. People, especially people who do not get treatment or support or information following a narcissistic relationship, over time may develop patterns that look like post-traumatic stress, depression, anxiety, or may be vulnerable to engaging in maladaptive coping behaviors, including drug or alcohol use, social withdrawal, or disordered eating. This is not a lesson. This is not something being worked out. This is harm. There are ways to get these lessons without having your heart being broken on a daily basis. After the fact, after you are out of a relationship like this, if you want to do the work, and I think you should, of extracting the meaning from the suffering, that's great. I really do believe it's a critically important part of the process of recovery. But I want you to do that after you are out. Staying in the relationship longer because you think it's a karmic relationship and you may extract more lessons? Absolutely not. When people do not get information about narcissism and other high conflict personality styles, as well as the harm caused by these personality styles, when people don't understand it, then they may remain in these trauma-bonded spaces, very confused. You know, it's like those horror films when the person is walking deeper and deeper into the scary house or down the scary road and you're kind of yelling at the screen like, don't do it, don't go down there, look at the scary monster, clearly is in that room and it's about to pop out and you're like, don't walk down that road. I feel like that's my entire professional life is telling people, please, oh please, don't walk down that road. There is no magic lesson lurking in a narcissistic relationship. There is no point staying one day longer than you need just to learn something. This relationship is not a hair shirt or an act of penance or a seminar in working through your past life or a past relationship or a past anything. Simply put, it's abuse. I recognize that there is, for lack of a better term, sort of the magical relationship industry out there. Twin flames, soulmates, past lovers, whatever the magical thing of the moment is. People do what they need to do to get themselves through this thing called life. And when it seems to be sort of lighthearted and not putting people in harm's way, then that's fine. You do you. But to me, this is not okay when abusive relationships are being framed as karmic relationships that are mystical places to work stuff through. Enduring abuse is not working through, it is harm. Can you think, honestly, of other relationship concepts that actually promote enduring abuse in a romantic relationship? Drop them in the comments, because that might actually give us more fodder for exploring these in future videos. Because I do think it's important that we be aware that sometimes these things are being framed as like, oh, this isn't a bad thing that happened to you. And then people sometimes feel guilty, like, why does this feel so bad? I understand that not everyone starts therapy in adolescence and figures out early in life what they need to work through. But I also know that most people, hell, most therapists, are not taught about narcissistic relationships until after they are in one. When people like me are trying to teach people about narcissism and narcissistic abuse before it happens to them, they tune me out and assume that I'm just a noisy buzzkill who is torching their fairy tales. Nobody who is being love bombed wants to hear about narcissism. But we need to teach this stuff in high school or earlier when people start dating, so they're aware of this and can pull themselves back from the edge before it really does some real harm to them. So please be very careful. If you are in a narcissistic relationship and are gliding through it thinking that it is some sort of karmic relationship that is giving you lessons and allowing you to work something through, nobody can really work stuff through while they are being psychologically harmed and manipulated and gaslighted and invalidated. At times when you're in a relationship that's so harmful, you're devoting all of your bandwidth to survival. I want to see everyone get educated, to learn the parameters of narcissistic relationships and how they work, and figure out a realistic path forward. Yes, there is meaning to be extracted from suffering. I absolutely believe that. But nobody would suggest that you hang out in the suffering a day longer than is needed in the name of getting more meaning. That's not how it works. So if you did enjoy this video or it was helpful, as always, please give it a thumbs up. Your engagement and feedback help this channel get to the people who need it. And as we can see, there's a lot of stuff out there that sometimes put people at harm and almost romanticize or downplay the dynamics of these very difficult relationship styles that can actually do harm to people. Thanks again.